Okay.
Finish.
Okay, students. Okay, Delta, good morning. Today we are going to practice, okay? We're going to practice the unit number 3 and the unit number 4 of the English book. Okay? Okay, and now please take your book and we're going to open the book in the page number 34, okay? The student book in the page number 34, we're going to practice the vocabulary of the unit number 1, unit number 2, unit number 3, and unit number 4, okay? If there are volunteers, please raise your hand, okay, to take you in consideration, okay? If you want to participate, raise your hand, okay? Okay. This activity is activity letter A. Listen, you have to listen, match, okay, match and write. Okay, in this case, you are not going to listen. No vamos a escuchar. Just look at the pictures, okay? Look at the picture and answer what is the correct vocabulary. For example, here, this picture is fix my computer. In the number one, volunteer Yaren Quispe, okay? Yaren Quispe, what is the number one?
Sew a parade.
Very good. Sew a parade, okay? Or see a parade, okay? Sew is the past of see. See es ver, sew es vio, ¿no? Sew a parade, okay? Very good. Sew a parade. The number, the next picture is fix my computer. And what is the last picture? What is this?
Town square.
Town square. Very good. Students, you are going to have 2 minutes, please. 2 minutes. And complete the correct word, okay? What is the correct word in the number two? Oh, the correct words in the number two, because we have 3 pictures, okay? What are the correct words in the number three? 1, 2, 3. And what are the correct words in the number 4, okay? In the number 1 is the vocabulary of the unit number 1. The number 2 is the vocabulary of the unit number 2. This is the unit number 3. And this is the unit number 4, the last unit, okay? El unidad anterior, the last unit. Okay, so you are going to have 2 minutes and complete, please. And then I'm going to choose volunteers, okay? Okay, let's start checking the answer. Volunteers for the second picture, okay? One moment, please. One moment. Okay. Keila Zamudio, Keila Zamudio, what is the second picture?
Medicine.
Okay, let's see. Yes, excellent, Keila. Medicine. The last picture, la última imagen, the last picture, Xiomara Gambini, what is the last picture?
Popcorn.
Popcorn, excellent. In the number 3, this is the picture of the vocabulary of the unit number 3, okay? Okay, Milei Ikaneke, what is the first picture?
Pour the milk.
Pour the milk. Yes, very good, Mileicita. Let's continue with the second picture. Quispe Yaren, what is the second picture?
Hit the pan.
Hit the pan. Excellent. And Janeline Hernandez, what is the last picture?
Slice the bananas, me.
Excellent, excellent. The last picture is slice the bananas. The unit 4, okay, the vocabulary of the unit 4. Alexander Gallegos Medina, what is the first picture?
Visit the miel.
Excellent. Visit the Nile, okay. Samirita Salcedo Luyo, what is the second picture? The next picture. Very good. Go on a tour. Excellent, Samirita. Said Chambi, what is, okay, ojalá que pueda responder. What is the last picture, Said Chambi?
Ride a jet ski.
Very good. Ride a jet ski. Excellent. Very good. If your answers are correct, si tus respuestas han sido correctamente o están bien, are correct, okay, make a check, okay, make a check, hazte un check, okay. Can I continue? Can I continue? I'm going to pass to the next activity, okay? Next activity. Yes, can I continue or no?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, okay, yes. Thank you so much. Yes. Okay.
Yes.
Okay, in the letter B, okay? In the letter B. Match, this is a student book in the page number 34.
Miss, apagó su audio.
Okay, students. Student book, page number 35. Okay? Match and write. You have to write or the answer. Yes, the answer of the question. Look at the number. What is the sentence question. That is this incomplete? Is the sentence or is the question? For example, in the number
the question here is this the dentist
where you got a checkup? Okay, and the answer is yes, it is. Okay, the question is the letter D. So the letter D is in the number one, no? You have to complete and write match here. The question with the letter, okay? The letter with a number, okay? Okay. In the number two, it's very easy. What is this place? The place.
This is the theater where I saw the show.
Very mm-hmm. good, student. This is the theater where I saw the show. Okay? This is the theater where I saw a show. Okay, let's take in consideration the vocabulary and the the letters in English, okay? The alphabet. Do you remember A, B, C, V, E, F, okay? Say the alphabet in English, okay? No in Spanish, no letra A in English. Letter A, letra B, no. Letter B, letter C, letter E, letter F, okay? Very good, okay. Two more minutes to complete the question in the number three. Please. Okay, in silence. Complete the question in the number three, in the number four, five, and in the number six. Remember, students, you have to match the letter with the number, okay? The letter with the number. For example, in the number two is the letter A. So I have to match letter A here. It is the letter A. Okay, letter A.
Ya terminé.
Mi sobre está apagado.
Thank you, Keila. Ángeles Valverde, in the number three, what is the question? What is the question, student? I'm going to choose victims, okay? Ángeles Valverde, what is the correct question in the number three?
This red feels like wood, doesn't it?
Okay, what is the correct letter?
B.
Okay, this bread feels like wood, doesn't it? Okay. Este pan se siente, ni siquiera dice sabe, se siente como madera, o sea, está muy duro, ¿no? Doesn't it? Yes, it does. It's a letter B. B. Okay. Oops. Okay, here is the letter B, okay? Complete, please, with the correct letter. In the number four, okay, you can raise your hand, but I'm going to choose a victim, okay? Fabricio Arana, in the number four, what is the correct answer? The question is, this juice tastes like plastic, taste, doesn't it?
Eso no me sale.
¿No te sale? Okay. Okay, 7 participants raise a hand. Okay. One moment, please. Participants, Samirita Salcedo Luyo, do you have the answer, Samirita? Yes or no? In the number four.
Mm-hmm. Yes, teacher. Yes, no, it doesn't. It tastes ok.
Okay, excellent, Samira. Yes. No, it doesn't. It tastes okay. This juice tastes like plastic, doesn't it? And the answer is no, it doesn't. It tastes okay. Okay. So the number four is the letter C. Yes? Right? Correcto? Right? Yes. In the number five, victim, Joshua Diego Eneke, in the number five, yes. Continue the sequence, okay? First, measure the flower. First, measure es mide, ¿no? First, measure the flower. Okay, what is next? Okay, Joshua is writing, okay? Él está escribiendo, Joshua is writing in the chat. Okay, Josh, estoy atenta a tu respuesta. Okay, remember, the number five. Okay. There is a sequence, hay una secuencia. Dice, first measure the flower. Primero añadimos, medimos la harina. First measure the flour. En este caso tenemos que buscar una de las opciones, letter A, B, C, E, F. Letter A ya no puede ser, ¿no?
Dicen
F. No, it doesn't.
F.
Será this bread in my wool, tampoco no puede ser, ese ya salió. Será uno de los dos.
Next mix the ingredients.
Ok, chicos, sí, los estoy escuchando perfectamente, gracias, pero ya había escogido a Joshua, ok. Cada uno ya tiene su tiempo de participación y ahorita va a escribir su compañero Joshua y ya escribió. Next mix the ingredients, ok. Very good. Thanks. Gracias a todos. Okay, next mix ingredient. This is the letter. Mix ingredient is the letter F. So the number five is the letter F, yes. Uh-huh. Okay, the number six. I'm going to look the participant. Thank you, Josh. Yeah, thank you, Josh. No problem, no hay problema. Gracias por tu participación. Thanks for the participation. Let's continue with the number six and is the last. Milei Ikaneke. Milei Ikaneke, do you know what is the number six, Milei? Yes?
Black He likes adventure.
Excellent. He might go hiking because he likes adventure. This is the letter. What letter is it? Milei? Is the letter?
A.
E. Uh-huh. Is the letter E. Okay. So complete here the letter. Okay, student. Thank you so much for your participation.
I finished, please.
Okay, if you finish and all the answers were okay, was okay, please make a check, okay? Make a check. Haces un check, okay? Okay, now let's continue with more activities. This is the student book in the page number 36. In the page number 36, we have two parts. Tenemos dos partes. The letter D, the activity letter D, and the activity letter E. First, activity letter D, okay? Read and write. It's very easy. Read and write. You have to choose two of the words. Buy a snack, or honey. Honey, ya sabes qué es la... ¿Qué es honey? ¿Se recuerdan?
Miel.
Ajá, la miel. Okay, says, Rachel remembers this place. This is the convenience store where she honey or where she buy a snack?
Buy a snack.
Because it's the convenience store, porque es la tienda, okay? Where she buy a snack. To eat last week. She remembers the bread she bought because it tastes like
honey.
Tastes like honey. She's going to come often to buy that bread. Okay? Let's continue with Jeff. In Jeff, we have to choose three phrases. Fry some eggs. Climb a mountain or like adventure. Okay, for example, Jeff, let's start with that reading. Jeff is having a good like time adventure. On vacations. Like, one moment, please. One moment. Jeff is having a good time on vacations. Each day he might, él podría, no? He might, or explore a cave.
Climb a mountain.
Climb a mountain. Yes, excellent. Because it's activity, ¿verdad? Porque es una actividad. Estamos explicando algo. Es una actividad. Eso, por ejemplo, acá también tenemos otra actividad. Entonces, siempre hay que mirar eso, ¿no, chicos?
He
might climb a mountain or explore a cave because, ahí tenemos la razón, ¿no?
Porque él,
porque
ama la aventura. Like adventure.
Very good.
Excellent students, because he likes adventure. This is the reason. Ahí tenemos la razón.
Y el otro es free some eggs.
Okay. Definitely the last is fry some eggs because es el último, ¿no? Porque es el último. Okay, he prepares a healthy snack to bring with him. First, he pours some fruit juice into a bottle. Next, he fries some eggs and makes sandwiches. Finally, he packs some fruits and nuts. Then he's ready to go. Okay, thank you, students. Okay, did you finish this activity?
Yes.
Yes. So we continue with the second part, okay? The second part is this. This is the second part. It's the activity letter E. Correct and rewrite. Okay? You have to write, but in this case, you're going to write correctly because a word is incorrect. For example, in the number one, the incorrect word is repair shop. This is the incorrect word. Why miss is incorrect? ¿Por qué es incorrecto? Porque no, de repente no tiene relación.
No es de la oración.
Claro, no, no tiene relación. Tenemos que buscar una palabra que sea apropiado, ¿no? O de repente le falta una letrita más, o de repente totalmente la palabra está errónea.
No, mi oración está mal.
Let's see, vamos a ver. This is the, here is a place, okay? This is the repair shop where you saw a show. Is the repair shop where you saw a show? Shop. Yes?
Theater.
No. In the repair shop, no. you no. can't saw repair a show. Shop, this is the theater. Yeah, theater. This is the theater where you saw a show. This is the correct word. So, change the incorrect word with the correct word. Okay, one moment, please. Vayan haciendo esa actividad. Person. Okay, students, now let's check the answers. Okay, in the number two, the incorrect word is this. Does bread taste like pepper? Okay, but bread is in singular, it's one bread. But here, the word says this. Okay, what is the correct word, Yaren? Yaren Quispe.
This bread tastes like pepper.
Excellent, Yaren. This bread tastes like pepper. Thank you, Yaren. Okay, why the difference, this or this? Porque ya sabemos que this significa este, ¿no? For example, this cell phone, este celular. This pencil, este lápiz. Utilizamos this, que la pronunciación es casi similar, cuando hablamos de varios objetos, varios animales, varias cosas, ¿no? For example, si tuviera varios lapiceros, sería this pens, ¿ok? Estos lapiceros. En ese caso está mal porque estamos hablando de un pan. Entonces sería this. This bread tastes like pepper. Let's continue with the number three. The mistake is added. What is the correct word, my dear Alexander Gallegos. First, Alexander Gallegos, do you want to participate? Yes?
First, me absorb the flow.
Okay, the correct word is add. First, add the flower, okay? Very good. First, add.
Measures.
Lo que pasa, corazón, es que, bueno, podemos decir measure the flour, que es medimos la harina, pero como acá la palabra es add, en sí nos está diciendo de que la palabra es añadir, entonces tenemos que escribir añadir, pero correctamente. Correctamente se dice add.
Ok, ¿no? Gracias.
Added, estamos hablando, no sé, es como que lo hubieran aumentado en pasado, ¿no? Primero añadió la harina, algo así, pero no está bien, no es correcto decir added, ¿ok? Very good. First, add the flour. Ok, let's continue with the number four. Let's continue with the number four. I'm going to choose to Joshua, Diego y Neke, ok, me respondes por el chat. The number four, answer by the chat. And let's continue with another students. Xiomarita, no levantó.
Mi Joshua respondió por el chat.
Ok, Josh, very good, thank you. Thank you, students. Okay, in the number four is he might, well, the incorrect sentences is he might goes on a safari because he loves animals. Okay, y Joshua ha escrito he might go. Okay, ahí se le ha escapado una N, pero yo sé que él ha querido escribir might, ¿no? He might go on a safari because he loves animals. Very good. Yes, Joshua. He might go on a safari. Ok. Ahora, yo les había dicho, chicos, que cuando haces una oración en presente con el pronombre personal he o she, por ejemplo, quiero decir ella canta. Se dice she sings, ¿verdad? Al verbo le aumentamos una S. O él juega. Se dice, he plays, se le aumenta una S, he plays, ¿no? Entonces, el verbo se altera cuando hablamos de ella o cuando hablamos de él, he or she. En este caso, dirás, Miss, ¿pero qué está he? Por eso que se altera el go, sería goes, ¿no? Pero no. Lo que pasa es que cuando utilizamos el auxiliar might, mejor dicho, cuando está el auxiliar, cuando hay un auxiliar, el verbo ya no cambia. Es igualito con do. He do homework. No, eso no es un verbo. Pero cuando utilizamos might, que es un auxiliar, el verbo sigue en su estado natural, ¿no? En su forma natural. No se altera. He might go on a safari because he loves animals. Let's continue with the number five. Have you escuchado? Samirita Salcedo Luyo, do you want to participate in the number five?
Mm-hmm. I might not climb a mountain because I am a square of eggs.
Very good, Samirita. I might not climb a mountain. Yo no podría escalar una montaña. I might not climb a mountain because I'm scared of eggs. Porque yo le tengo miedo a las alturas. ¿Ok? Entonces, I'm, aunque no lo crean, el am es el, si no me equivoco, es el verb to be. Es el verbo ser o estar. Eso le da a la oración esa partecita que dice yo estoy, yo tengo, ¿no? Porque el verbo es ser o estar. En este caso, acá le falta, arribita le falta el verb to be, por eso que es incorrecto. Dice, yo miedo a las alturas. Sin embargo, acá ya está completo.